mushroom?
Yeah.
Hang on, let me try something.
Alright, hold on a second. Let me just get over there for a quick second.
Okay.
Yeah, that arc is just perfect.
So I'm wondering something.
Alright, you're wondering something?
I am, okay. I am playing the game now, so let's.
Alright, yeah. This. Oh, I get what you're doing there. Yeah.
It's going the wrong way, though. Yeah, that was my thought, but it
no, no,
the
it,
wrong
it,
way.
You'll,
Oh, I need to do
this
again.
Yeah, the P switch again. Bring the other spring with you. Maybe that's the key.
Maybe.
No, yeah. See if that'll bounce it back eventually. Go. You have to activate the P switch again.
All right.
But I know what you're getting at though. Now that I'm looking at it.
See if you can go boing.
Boing. Back. Boing, oh.
Winner.
Winning. Winning. That was brilliant.
Thank you. Okay. So now let's.
It's a matter of dropping.
Go down here.
And you'd have to activate the bomb, grab it, and then throw it up. Yeah.
Boom.
Now you have to activate the thing, get another mushroom on that side.
Yep. Because you need to have all of the mushrooms in place before you move the springs.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's going to be stuck there now.
Yeah, that's going to be stuck there. Now you can just go and throw up a spring to the... toss it up there. Boom! And you're gonna need...
Alright. Whoops.
You're gonna have to redo the whole thing. Nope, you're gonna have to redo the whole thing.
I have it.
You're gonna need to redo the whole thing.
This out.
You're gonna have to redo the whole thing! You forgot your spring!
I did. I have figured this out, though.
You forgot your spring!
I have solved the puzzle, though.
You have forgotten your spring!
I have.
How could you do that?
Yeah, a little ahead of myself. But that does work, though.
I'm just really shocked about how you can do the springs activate POWs.
Yeah, that is surprising.
Oh, no. More or less.
Awesome,
yeah, this is really good. That is a really good idea. Boom right there, and then
and get your other mushroom.
You need your mush.
Gotta have that mush.
Always have your mush. And now that'll stick there. Bam. Bring your spring with you.
So then you need that. You also need the P-switch again.
Yes, you do need the P-switch again. I'm gonna.
As soon as I put it down, then you can. There you go. Boom.
Bam! That was good! That was a good level. I like that.
That was a really cool level. I like that. These one room puzzles are so clever.
I know, right? Definitely star that.
Absolutely. 33 seconds.
I know. And there's no, like, dev trick secret to that one. It's
no,
just a matter of hoofing
just pure,
it.
No, that one's just pure speedrun.
That is straight up hoof. That's all you need.
Okay. So, what am I doing?
You're gonna learn to ride a lift with style.
Okay, I can do that.
But it only counts if you do so with style points.
Yes. There is a door.
There are many doors. I wonder if that would crush you if you just fall out the bottom.
I don't know. Let's not find out.
I think you would just fall out the bottom.
Ooh, that is a tight gap.
Just for you. Wow, you're gonna have to, you have to plane it and keep going.
Yeah.
You stopped, you gotta keep going.
My jumping trigger.
Yeah, that's
there
it.
There we go. Now what?
Oh, you've got to keep going.
Oh.
Yeah, you got to keep going with that one up to the top, to the other one over before it, before they all go to the top section there.
Well then.
Well then.
Ooh,
nope.
That is tight.
That is very tight. You got to be ready to hoof. Get with yo style. Yeah, no. You got to stay above the blockers.
Yeah.
What are those things called?
Gates? I call them gates.
Oh, almost had it. Almost had it.
So you just gotta keep running, basically.
Yeah. See, that's it. That's all you have to do. It's not that hard.
This is gonna be another thing like the turtle episode.
Yeah, no, exactly. It's gonna be a turtle episode. I don't think we'll ever top that, thankfully.
Yeah, I hope not, because that was painful.
That was very painful. There it is, got it.
Got it. Nailed it.
Yeah, nailed it. Esports after the fifth or sixth time.
Ooh,
damn. You got a hoof.
Ah, oh, so close.
But yet so far.
Yes.
You gotta do a light jump.
Uh-huh.
I think a light jump is where that's gonna be at. That is very tight, though. I don't know if you want to try to do a super jump. I think that little hook right there that's right above you right now is too much to,
I'm just curious for a preview of what's coming up.
It looks like it's madness. That little nook right there is enough to prevent you from jumping from the first to the third
yeah,
one.
Yeah, yeah. I was eyeing that as well. Nope. Damn, you gotta be real freaking quick on this one. For some reason there's like a pause when Mario goes back and forth that he doesn't keep his momentum like right there. Huh.
You're already too far behind.
Yeah, that was a lost cause.
When you, right after this little hook here, can you hold hard right and make it to the blue platform anyway, or is it too much of a gap?
I don't know. No, because it's above you at that point, the blue one is. So you have to jump. Jesus.
It's pretty tight.
That is some boss timing.
Just for you.
Hey.
Oh my goodness, gasp. Don't lose your platform. You have to rush after it.
Oh.
that's tough. You have to immediately get up there as fast as possible, and then immediately drop down so that you can then bounce off of the jelly thing.
Oh no! Oh, this is tight.
Is it possible to jump up in advance? Jump up in advance, yeah. Don't just ride it. You have to. Yeah. That's the right idea. And then. There it is!
Ah, I win. Ah!
Yeah, you won.
A winner was me for about 5 seconds.
Yeah! Okay, you gotta stop hitting your forehead.
So I think I can just do this.
Nope. That last one you're gonna have to do a quick tap on the jump right there would have been.
So yeah, it's the quick tap and then I think you just have to run.
From there, yeah.
From there, yeah. And my jump didn't trigger again. This controller was weird with the jump button sometimes.
I know, it was brand new, and now it just doesn't want to function as well.
Mm.
Not even that much use on it.
No.
Oh, you almost had it. You almost had it. You jumped too late.
There's a checkpoint, though.
Does that make you feel better?
Yes.
There it is. Boom.
Got it. Let's see what horrors await. Giving me lots of mush.
Whoa. Yeah, and I think you're gonna need it.
Hello.
Dad, you jumped way too early.
Yeah, I saw that.
But then again, I'd be willing to bet you're not the only one that done that, though.
Like watching somebody drop a deck of cards?
I think it's not as bad as it looks. It's just a matter of the tension factor of, oh my god, a saw blade's coming after me. What do I do? Are you happier now that you got your one up?
I am.
Are you sad now that you're small?
Yes. Well, I don't know which way to go.
I'm gonna guess and say...
Not that way.
Left. Not left. Don't listen to me. I apparently don't know what I'm doing.
Go left, he says.
Go left. Oh, but you have to.
I get it.
So I was right.
I get it now. Okay.
No, you're not going to make that all in one hoof.
Yeah.
Way too early.
Yeah.
That's a cool concept, though. You gotta time your platform jumps.
It is. This is really cool.
This is literal platforming.
Yes. Platforming to the extreme. Alright. Nope.
Yeah, because that first one you land on actually falls off the track, so it's not there. So you have to make that super hoof from this one. Right there, all the way over.
Yeah, that's tough. That's really tough. Oops.
It almost like it leads me to believe that you need to land on that set that this platform. You need to land on it on the leftmost corner of it, so that you have a full run on it to then jump, so that you have as much momentum hoofing yourself to the right as possible. But you have to do it in one fluid motion because you don't have time to set yourself up, and you exploded. Are you feeling better?
Yes.
Yeah, that moment right there, but you don't have time to set yourself up. You just have to land and go.
Yeah.
There's no time to... Oh, my Mario's not the perfect spot, so I gotta...
That is really tight.
Exactly. You just have to go with it. Land on that platform with as much space to run, but no matter where you land, you gotta keep going.
Ah, so close. Yeah, this is tough.
It is tough.
This is really tough. Oh, I would have had that if my jump had actually worked.
I believe you were jumping, but in the air that time. Not gonna happen. No. You're not gonna make it if you do that, you know, that air brake, double take. There it is.
What?
How did that happen?
I was on there.
That was some bullshit.
That was some bullshit.
There's a gap between the two where the wings are. That's what happened.
That was some bullshit.
There's a gap right where the wings are. You got robbed.
That was some bullshit. There we go. There it is.
You told it who was boss.
I did. Oh god, they're giving me another mush.
You're gonna need your mush. Over. Yeah. And back.
Oh, you gotta go back now. Okay,
yeah.
Okay. I get it.
That's hella tense. Oh, you gotta do all that all over again.
God damn it.
Just for you. How does this level make you feel?
It's cool. I like the concept. It's really good. Well done. Really well executed. It has a very fair difficulty curve, I feel, as well, because I kind of introduce you to the concept and then slowly ramp it up.
Yup. And hey, look at that!
Boom.
Like a boss. It's not gonna drop if you're right there.
Give me my mush.
You want yo mush. It's, yeah... What? Oh, it's a block there. You're supposed to ride that down, go over, then come back.
Right. I need to remember the order of events.
You think you thunk?
I think I thunk. Yeah, this is a really cool level.
How about that saw blade? Is the saw blade really cool?
It is.
I like how they put that one mush, that one one up there just to make you feel a little bit better about it. Even though ultimately it doesn't mean anything. And now you're getting this one every time.
Okay, so for this one it is over, then back, then over, then back.
That made no sense at all.
So it's over,
down.
Down.
Yes, that's where you're, and
now over again.
Not into the saw blade.
Not into the saw blade. So it's over, down, over, then over, back the other way, and then up again, I believe.
I believe, as you say, are you sure you're for yourself there?
Nope, but we'll go with it.
You have a plan? You need your plan of attack. Is jumping into lava part of your plan?
Yes.
The looks of it, you're not the only one. What I don't get is why there's another mushroom pipe there.
I don't know. They're giving you lots of mushrooms.
Even though there's no way to get back up there once you come down here.
Yeah.
Like, that's where it gets really kind of weird and confusing.
Just to make you wonder.
Does it make you feel better that you got a life back?
Yes.
Now you're back to your favorite room.
Okay,
Yeah, that saw blade likes you.
It does. Likes a lot of other people as well.
It's almost like you have to jump as late as possible in order to,
yeah, I think that's exactly it.
In order to get the arc low enough on the saw blades.
Mm-hmm.
On the way up, I think jumping back the other direction is going to be far easier.
Yeah.
And then it's going to get very difficult again once you got to then, like, jump, jump, jump. Because once you get on top of all those saw blades, it looks like you gotta double jump all across all the platforms.
Yep.
It's a hella good level, though.
It is. It's really nice. I like how it's sticking to that same theme throughout the whole thing, and then just incrementally making it more and more
ramping
difficult.
It up, kind of like how your character likes hot baths and is incrementally ramping himself into the hot bath more and more often.
I know, right? He's done with that other room. He doesn't want to do it again.
Just end it now. I don't want to. He doesn't want to deal with it.
He's like, this is not in my contract. This is not covered by my health insurance.
Yeah, exactly. Do I get hazard pay? You got this room down, though.
Yeah. Oh, whoops. Mm.
Like a boss, not even taking the mushroom and taking the saw blade to the head.
Oops, I forgot. I got too excited.
You were like, yay, this room again!
Actually, in retrospect, not having the mushroom might make it easier because you have a smaller hitbox then.
But the one that was always killing you was the one that was, you were small by then.
Quiet.
just saying.
Silence, I don't need your details.
You just need a hot bath, that's what you need. You and about 50 other people.
Is it the community jacuzzi down there?
Because that's one thing I've always wondered about, and I've discussed this prior, about, you know, the economy and the ongoings of the Mushroom Kingdom.
I was actually just going to say, I wonder what health insurance actually exists in the Mushroom Kingdom.
I don't think health insurance does exist, but what I'm curious is, like, do they need to outsource their lava in order to get it in their castle to have a moat for?
Apparently.
Is there factories that just make these platforms?
Yep.
You know, do different Goombas head off to, like, I work at the track factory, this guy works over at the, at the platform factory, this other, you know, the other Koopa over here, I work at the saw blade factory. You know, I just, things I've always wondered about.
Yeah.
What kind of construction force do they got going on in here?
I know. Oh, whoops.
Way too late. You were daydreaming.
I was,
You were off thinking about the workforce that was required to build this wonderful contraption.
I was, actually.
Just for you. That was great. You had it going. It was great. And then it was like, oh, that is a good thought. Oh, wait, I'm supposed to be doing things. Because I'm just wondering, like, how does the economy work in the Mushroom Kingdom, you know?
I was like, that'd be a great webcomic if somebody did that.
Yeah, it's gotta exist somewhere.
It has to.
There's gotta be a fanfic on someone's computer at some point that explains all this. You know, like, who works at the Spikes Factory? I know who works at the Spikes Factory, it's Billy.
Billy.
Freaking Billy.